Welcome to Java Forum. Now we are going to see how to install and configure Ubuntu 20.04 long-term support edition, codenamed as Focal Fossa on VirtualBox 6.1 with guest editions. So here you can see that I already downloaded Ubuntu 20.04 desktop edition. So we are going to install desktop edition of Ubuntu 20.04 long term support edition. So first I am creating one new virtual machine. So I am giving some name to that virtual machine. Also I am selecting the destination directory where the virtual machine is to be installed. So this Ubuntu 20.04 long-term support edition is a much awaited release. So now I am giving RAM size and also I am allocating 30 GB of hard disk to virtual hard disk to this virtual machine. Next boot order, I am selecting optical drive to be first under system. So processor core, I am selecting 4-core processor. So storage, I am going to select Ubuntu 20.04 desktop ISO file. So we are going to install Ubuntu 20.04 long term support from this ISO file. So these are all the VirtualBox 6.1 settings for Ubuntu 20.04 long term support edition. So let us start the Ubuntu 20.04 long term support, code named as Focal Fossa. So VirtualBox 6.1 supports kernel 5, Linux kernel 5. So better you update latest version of VirtualBox. So Ubuntu 20.04 long term support edition supports kernel version of 5.4 and GNOME desktop version 3.36. So this is a new look of this Ubuntu 20.04 long term support edition. So here you can see that install screen had appeared. So I am clicking the button try Ubuntu. So why I am clicking try Ubuntu is we are going to install the Ubuntu in full screen mode. So I click the button called try Ubuntu. Yes. So now let me change the display settings. So I am going to increase the screen resolution according to my monitor resolution. So this is a temporary change only. So now let us start to install Ubuntu 20.04 long term support edition. So this install will be in full screen. So English will be the default language. Keyboard layer also will be English US keyboard. So normal installation only. So make sure that you are connected to the internet to download the latest updates. Also you need internet connection to install VirtualBox guest edition dependencies. Make sure that you are connected to the internet. So again screen may flicker. So again I am adjusting the screen resolution once again. Yes, so again I have adjusted the screen resolution. So installation type, so first option I have selected, erase the disk and install Ubuntu. This will be useful for the beginners. So let me select the location. So next I am providing the username, password and computer name. Yes, so installation in progress. So I have listed down the Ubuntu 20.04 long-term support features in the description of this video. So installation is completed. So I am going to click the button continue testing. Click the button continue testing. Don't click the button restart now. So now I am going to power off. Yes, so now you can see that virtual machine is powered off. So now right click settings. You can see that optical disk ISO file had got removed. So now I am adding the VirtualBox guestedition.iso file. So this is the path of VirtualBox guestedition.iso file. So I am going to install and configure VirtualBox guestedition's now. So optical drive I am unchecking. So hard disk will be the boot disk. So it will be boot from hard disk directly now. So now I am starting the Ubuntu 20.04 long term support. So let me log into the machine. So after the install, I am logging for a first time. So I am clicking next button. I am skipping some steps. If you want, you can configure your initial settings accordingly. So I am done with my initial settings. So once again, I am changing the display settings. So after installation, I am changing the display settings for the first time. So according to my monitor resolution, I have changed the resolution. So this will be the permanent So you can see that these are the list of softwares available. So and this is the settings available for Ubuntu 20.04. So you can navigate one by one. So and this is the detail about the machine. So you can see that I have mounted the VirtualBox Guest Edition 6.1. So I have opened the terminal now. So now I am logging as a root user. So make sure that you are connected to the internet. because we are going to install the dependencies for VirtualBox guest edition software. So this is the command apt-get install space gcc space make space perl. So do you want to continue? Yes, type y. So this will download all the dependency file required by VirtualBox guest edition software. So this will take some time, depends upon your internet connection. All the dependencies will be got downloaded and installed. So instead of offline install of VirtualBox guest edition, this online install will be easier for beginners. So make sure that you have a good internet connection connected to your virtual machine so that you can download this dependencies. Yes, so all these dependencies are downloaded and got installed successfully. So now I am going to install the VirtualBox guest edition. So this is the command dot vbox linux editions dot run. So this will install the guest edition software. Yes, it was successfully installed. So we need to reboot this machine. So I am going to reboot this Ubuntu 20.04 long term support virtual machine. So first I am power off the virtual machine. So I am going to make some changes in settings. Right click settings. So in general advanced tab, shared clipboard bidirectional, and drag and drop also I am selecting as bidirectional. Okay, so once again I am starting the virtual machine so that all the changes will be reflected. Yes, now I am going to log into the machine after installing the VirtualBox guest edition software. Let us see what is going to happen. Yes, you can see that 20.04 LTS edition had started in full screen. So now let us navigate the softwares installed one by one. So this is the system monitor software. So next this is LibreOffice Calc. So LibreOffice 6.4 is installed in Ubuntu 20.04 desktop edition. So it contains all office suite software, LibreOffice writer. So next is browser Firefox. So Firefox 75 is available by default. So all are updated softwares. So latest free and open source softwares are installed. So Firefox 75 is available by default. So now let me open the terminal and check whether what are the programming languages installed. So let me check Java is installed by default. No. Python 3 is available by default. So Python 3.8 is available by default. Perl 5.30 is available by default. So these are the free and open source programming languages available in the Ubuntu 20.04 long term support edition. So Linux kernel 5.4 is the kernel version available in this release. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this command line output to Windows host machine to check the shared clipboard functionality. So I'm in Windows operating system now and I'm going to paste the content. Yes. So shared clipboard feature is working fine in Ubuntu 20.04 long term support edition after installing the VirtualBox guest edition software. Now I am copying the text from Windows to Linux. Yes, I can able to paste the text from Windows to Linux. So once again I try to copy the command output from the terminal to the Windows Notepad++. I'm copying and paste. Yes, so shared clipboard is working fine in Ubuntu 20.04 long term support edition.